On August 24th, 2017, Nikon launched the Nikon D850. Little did they know, it would become one of the most beloved DSLRs to date, and it would shame the competition. A cult developed that exists to this day, and I believe has held up more people from switching to mirrorless than probably any other camera from any brand. But does it hold up in a rapidly changing camera world, and is it still a good buy? We are answering that question in this video. Some interesting facts about the Nikon D850. It did indeed win Camera of the year that it was launched, and it was the first Nikon camera to have a backside illuminated sensor, which nowadays is kind of standard. With the exception of a few models, Nikon puts BSI in all of their mirrorless cameras. It was also the first DSLR that DxO Mark gave a score of 100 to. Now, I don't really play the DxO Mark style game because I'm all about feel, fun, and photography, not deep spec dives and charting. But that is impressive nonetheless. Finally, the D850 has had only one or two firmware updates ever, and they were features, not fixes, if I recall correctly. So Nikon basically launched a camera that had no bugs. That is kind of unbelievable. Moving on, I absolutely am not going to get into specs. This camera is old as far as camera tech goes, and I'm sure you have heard or can find the details anywhere else. But in a nutshell, it's fast, it's high megapixel, it's accurate, it will do anything, and it really does live up to its legendary status of being one of the best DSLRs not just Nikon, but any brand has ever made. Depending on who you talk to, this might be fact. Politely, fight it out in the comment section.
So Z-Wade, how come you only shot one and never owned one?
Well, I have a terrible quality early Z-Wade photo YouTube video that explains it all. But since I do not want you seeing that trash fire, I'll just tell you that it was too thick for my hand and I could barely get a grip on it. It felt like it was going to slip constantly. But that's not Nikon's fault, that's my genetics' fault. Is it a good buy in a mirrorless world? Well, we have to sort some stuff out first. First fact, at the making of this video, there are way more lens options for the Nikon D850's F-mount than there is for Nikon's Z-mount. Fact, in many cases, the cheapest Z-glass is often better in most ways than F-mount glass, with the exception of some legendary lenses. When those legends make their way over to mirrorless, they will probably be better. Nikon has learned some things since F-mount. Keep in mind that lens shopping is more fun in F-mount because lenses had their own personalities back then. Anywho, we have two facts that kind of battle each other. Options versus performance, and you can decide which one you like. Second, image output has not changed much from the D850 to something like a Z8 or Z9. Essentially, the same thing. Nikon files are Nikon files, and they have been for a while. They rock. Yes, Z lenses are technically better, but stop pixel peeping. The D850 files do not look dated. They look amazing. Third, performance-wise, it definitely stands on its own two feet for everything. It's amazing. A jack of all trades until you get into sports and wildlife, where the opinion is kind of split. I never shot either genre with a D850, but I've heard both sides. Some folks thought it lacked tracking ability with wildlife, but not sports. It did well in wildlife, but not sports, and many consumers had no issues either way. I don't know who to believe. Anyone with this experience, let us know how you feel in the comments to help out anyone who may be shopping right now. I'd say if you're doing some serious work in these high-speed action scenes, probably get a D5 or a D6 if you are certain of what we are going to get into right now. Is the D850 still a good buy? Hell yes! If you already know you don't want to switch or do not like the mirrorless experience, there is no right or wrong. The EVF versus OVF argument is dumb. It's just preference until the day that refresh speeds are so good that you can't tell a difference, which may take decades. By the way, it won't even be DSLR versus mirrorless, it will be quantum or some shit. If you already know that you don't want to go mirrorless, the D850 was a lot of camera at its launch price. It's an even better value now and stupid value in excellent used condition. However, if you haven't tried mirrorless, don't knock it until you try it. I was one of those people that after a few days getting used to the electronic viewfinder and being able to see my exposure and the exposure meter and making decisions based on both, I was all in. I love mirrorless. If you have not tried mirrorless, I just have to tell you that that is where the industry is and will continue going, and it's worth trying before making your final decision. rent a mirrorless camera and an f1.8 S-line Z lens for a weekend, then make your final decision. In conclusion, the D850 is not dead, and it may not be until there are no more. If anything, it may become a collector piece with all of the love that surrounds it. But make sure you know for sure before you buy, because it is still kind of expensive. Stay sharp, YouTube.